The functional assessment-based intervention model employs a systematic approach to designing, implementing, and evaluating functional assessment-based procedures developed by Embright, Farrow, Leopsin, and Lane, 2007. As you may recall, the first three steps are as follows. Step 1, identifying students who need a FABI. Step 2, conducting the functional assessment where they have identified a student in need of a FABI and conducted the functional assessment to discover reasons why challenging behaviors occur, the function, and step 3, collecting baseline data, the target or replacement behavior was selected for monitoring appropriate measurement systems, and present levels were recorded for ideally around 5 observations. This video introduces you to step 4, designing the intervention. As part of this process, teams begin designing the intervention by working through the function-based intervention decision model to guide intervention planning. The function-based intervention decision model includes 2 questions to guide intervention design. The first question asks, can the student perform the replacement behavior? And the second question asks, do antecedent conditions represent effective practice? Answers to these 2 questions help focus interventions that are directly linked to the results of the Functional Behavior Assessment, FBA, and employ 1 of 3 methods. Here, you see the function-based intervention decision model and how the answers to 2 questions correspond to 1 of the 3 methods. Method 1, teach the replacement behavior, is suited for when the student cannot perform the replacement behavior and antecedent conditions represent effective practice. Method 2, improve the environment, which is recommended for when the student can perform the replacement behavior and antecedent conditions do not represent effective practice. It is important when answering this question to consider the extent to which the environment represents effective practices for this student. A classroom teacher may implement outstanding classroom practices in teaching and classroom management that the majority of his or her students are responding well to, but they may not be effective for this specific student. Method 3, adjust the contingencies, is recommended for when the student can perform the replacement behavior and antecedent conditions represent effective practices. Lastly, there is a combination of Method 1 and Method 2, teach the replacement behavior and improve the environment, and it is used for when the student cannot perform the replacement behavior and antecedent conditions do not represent effective practices for this student. Once an intervention method is selected, it is important to develop intervention tactics across 3 core components for a FABI, referred to as the ARE components, based on function as identified from the functional assessment in step 2 and the intervention method identified using the function-based intervention decision model, antecedent adjustments, reinforcement adjustments, and extinction procedures are developed to either teach the replacement behavior, improve the environment, or adjust the contingencies, or a combination of teach the replacement behavior and improve the environment. Once the intervention method is selected and ARE components are drafted and linked to the hypothesized function identified during the functional assessment, a draft treatment integrity form specifying the intervention is made and shared with stakeholders. Social validity surveys are used to make sure the teacher, parents, and student have consensus on the goals, are comfortable with the procedures, and believe the intervention is likely to achieve the desired outcomes. If there are serious concerns for any one of the parties, such as the student is embarrassed or the teacher does not feel the plan is feasible, procedures are revisited and modified accordingly. Once finalized, the teacher and student are trained in the procedures and implementation materials are prepared. When the procedures are taught to the key stakeholders involved in implementing the intervention, be certain to conduct a check for understanding to make certain each person is entirely clear on how to put the intervention in place. Often, Baseline data collection will continue during this phase, along with IOA as necessary. Additional baseline data should be collected before or after a break in school before introducing the intervention in Step 5, testing the intervention, as it is important not to conduct phase changes over a break. In the last step, we will focus on Step 5, testing the intervention, which will focus on answering three questions to draw accurate conclusions regarding the effectiveness of the FABI. To learn more about these processes, you may explore our video on the function-based intervention decision model. You may also review Applied Behavior Analysis, second edition, by Cooper, Heron, and Heward, 2007, and Functional Behavior Assessment and Function-Based Intervention, an Effective Practical Approach by Umbright, Farrow, Leopsen, and Lane, 2007.